Thank you. 公平。
Cheerfully free. I have heard people
about?
Yes. You say you are a fugitive. When you joined the Navy, what were you running away from? The ladies, the wives of the brothers, often go to Australia during the hot months. It can get very hot here.
It can get hot in Little Rock, too.
It can?
Hot.
I have many books here, Marcel Proust, André Gide. Did you study French in school?
Oh, yes.
Or even read French?
No. I can conjugate a few verbs. I'll bet you read a lot.
Out here, one becomes hungry to learn everything, not to miss anything, not to let anything good pass by.
Yes.
One waits so long for what is good. When at last it comes, one cannot think to lose. So, one must speak and act quickly, even though it seems almost foolish to me. Why, now it is only 2 weeks. It was a dinner given at your officer's club.
Wasn't it?
That is the way things happen sometimes. Isn't it, Nelly?
Isn't it, Nelly?
You'll meet your strange wife. What a thousand more.
You're in a trap!
together.
Yeah? What's it made out of?
Made out of hands. It's real human. See?
Well, what makes it so small?
Slunk. Only want to kiss human head is shrink of
no thanks. What else you got there, Mary?
Bobala. The man Chicago for sacks his sweetheart. He make wave like this.
Hey, look, fellas, it's Moe! These beautiful graph skirts were made by myself, the professor here, and three other CVs, naval construction engineers, and half the time it takes your native workers to make them. See? No stretch. Look them over, sweaty pie, and give me your price, huh?
Look at that shirt! Take it up with the manager! Hey, big dealer! You look so good!
Well, what can I do for you, my boy? What's your trouble?
Look at that shirt!
The Phyllis Laundry is not responsible for minor burns and tears.
Well, what do you say, nurse? What's up with my offers?
All hands on.
That's mighty nice work.
You hear that? You can probably sell these chunks for $5 or $6 a piece. Now, come on, let's make a quick deal, huh?
Look, I'll let you have the whole bunch for, say, $80.
$10.
What?
Is that enough?
You're damn well right it's not enough.
Then you done well.
Now, look here, Dragon. What have you got there? A forestry placement? Where'd you get that? Over down the valley high?
You like?
You guys know what this is? A placement made out of a single board tube. They cut the tooth out of the board's mouth in a big ceremonial over there on Valley High. There ain't a souvenir you can pick up from the South Pacific as valuable as this.
What would you want for this, Mary?
$100.
$100?
Man, that's cheap. I thought it'd be more.
I don't see how she can turn them out for that.
Hey! I got you a special offer, Big Dealer. A 20-year-old bar suit bracelet for all grass skirts.
That's the deal.
1 minute. It's no deal till you throw in something for good luck.
Okay, what do you want me to throw in?
$100. Good luck!
Now listen. You don't run across these things every day, you know. They're scarce as hen's teeth.
They're bigger, too.
Oh, that damn belly. Why does it have to be out of bounds? You can get everything over there. Shrunken head, bracelets, old ivory.
Young French women!
Knock off. I'm talking about souvenirs.
Those teeth.
Don't get over there. I'm feeling held down again. I need to take a trip.
Oh, the officers can sign out both.
I'll get up for it all right. I'll latch on to some officer that's got some imagination. Some guy would like to see that boar's tooth ceremonial as much as I would. Ooh, that's a hell of a ceremonial. Dancing. Drinking. Everything.
Why, you big bully, we all know why you want to go to Valley High.
Yeah, why?
Because the French planters put all their young women on there when they heard the GIs were coming.
That's why.
It ain't 14th. But dang, it is 14th.
We got sunlight on the sand, we got moonlight on the sea.
We got mangoes and bananas you can pick right off the tree.
We got volleyball and ping pong and a lot of dandy games. But what ain't we got?
We ain't got dandy.
We get packages from home, we get movies, we get shows.
And advice from Tokyo Road.
We get little stuff with toys. Do we get dizzy from the smell?
What don't we get?
Hello, damn well.
We have nothing to put on a clean white suit for. What we need is what there ain't no such stuff to for.
There is nothing like a day.
Particular thing that is nothing whatsoever in any way, shape, or form like any other.
There is nothing like a day.
Yeah, I did it all last night. You don't have to open it here.
Why, you do beautiful work, Luther. You've even done the pleats in my shorts.
Oh, pleats ain't hard. You better run along and catch up with your gang.
Well, pleats are very hard. How do you do such delicate work at night in the dark?
There was a moon.
There was a moon.
A full moon.
How much, Luther?
Oh, no, not from you.
Gosh, I guess I'm just about the luckiest nurse on the island to have found you. You're a treasure. Goodbye, Luther.
Hey!
Yeah, I may call.
back as the French planters have their young women running around over there. Of course, you being an officer, you could get a launch. I'd even be willing to requisition one for you.
What do you say, Lieutenant?
Valley High may call you any night, any day. In your heart, you'll hear it call you. Come away, come away.
Well, Lieutenant?
Oh,
yeah, I see what you mean about the island being out of bounds and all. Take a hell of a lot of persuading to get me to go over there. You know, they got another little thing over there, Lieutenant. They got this ceremonial of a boar's tooth. See, after they kill the boar, they pass around some of this coconut liquor and women dance with just skirts on. Everybody gets to know everybody
pretty well.
Of course, it's just a little old tribal ceremonial. Primitive, but astonishing. I thought with you being up in the shooting war for such a long time without getting any recreation, I thought you might be interested.
I am. But right now, I've got to report to the island commander.
Oh, Professor, take the lieutenant up in the truck.
Professor?
Yeah, we call him Professor because he went to college. You go to college?
Yes.
Yeah, where?
Princeton University.
Oh, your folks have money, huh? Well, don't be ashamed of him, Lieutenant. We understand. Hey, maybe you'd like to hear the professor talk some language, huh? What would you like to hear? We got Latin, Grecian. Give him some Latin. Yeah, come on, give him a little Latin, all you got.
Give him a Latin lesson. Come on. Rectius revet licini.
Ain't that sensational?
Neque alto. Semper cogendo dum cogela.
Well, how about it, Lieutenant? What did he say?
I'm afraid I haven't the slightest idea.
What's the matter? Didn't you graduate? All right, take the lieutenant up to the building.
Aye, aye. Don't ever make captain. Iron belly, iron belly, iron belly. Here he is, sir. You are causing an economic revolution on this island. These French planters can't find a native to pick a coconut or milk a cow because you're paying them 10 times as much to make these ridiculous grass cuts.
French planters, please stop it!
Sir! May I make a suggestion, sir?
Who are you?
Luther Phillips. The natives can now go back to work on the farm, sir. The demand for grass skirts can now be met by us CBs.
Dressmakers? Do you mean to tell me the construction engineers of the United States Navy are now sitting around in sewing circles?
You don't like the idea, sir. Just say the word. We'll drop the whole subject. Just pretend I never brought it up.
Luther Phillips.
Yes, sir?
Nothing. Just making a mental note. I want to be sure not to forget your name. I want to see you pick up every scrap of this paraphernalia now, and for the last time, carry it down there beyond that fence. All Navy property.
Take all that stuff and throw it on that fence. Off Navy property. Off Navy property. Come on, get it out of here. Let's go.
All right. You go, too.
All right, Miss Anna. Thank you.
Lieutenant, who are you anyway?
I'm Lieutenant Joseph Cable, sir. Just flew in on that Catalina.
Joey Wright?
No, sir, Otto.
And I'm reading and the orders to me.
Yes, sir.
I'm Captain Mike.
Howdy, sir.
And this is Commander Hobson, my executive officer.
Howdy, sir.
Well, what's it all about?
My colonel feels that all these islands are in danger because none of us has been getting first-hand intelligence. What we need is a coast watch.
Coast watch?
A man with a radio hiding out on one of those jet-held islands where he could watch for jet ships when they start down the bottleneck. Down this way.
What do you think, Bill? Well, sir, our pilots could do a hell of a lot with Jap convoys with information like that. You'd have to sneak this man ashore at night from the submarine.
Yes.
Who's going to do it?
Well, sir, I've been elected.
You've got quite an assignment, son. How long do you think you could last there, sending out messages before the Japs found you?
I think I'd be okay if I could take a man with me who really knew the country. Headquarters has found out there's a French civilian here who used to have a plantation on Marie Louise Island.
Marie Louise? That's a good spot right on the bottleneck. What's this Frenchman's name?
Emile de Beck.
Meet me in my office in a half an hour, Cable.
Yes, sir.
Come on, Bill. Maybe you and I are going to get into this war yet. Together on the GI Entertainment Committee. Oh, May I also present Lieutenant Joseph Cable, Miss Baldwin? Well, sit down, Miss Baldwin. How's the Thanksgiving entertainment coming along?
Very well, thank you, sir. We practice whatever we get a chance.
About a week ago, you had lunch with a French planter, Emile Debec.
Yes, sir.
What do you know about him?
What do I know about him?
That's right.
We met at the Officers Club dance. He was there. And I met him. So then I had lunch with him that day.
Yes. What kind of a man is he?
Very nice. Kind. He's attractive. I just don't know what you want to know, sir.
Forbesson. Captain Brackett wants to know, did you discuss politics?
No, sir.
Would you have discussed politics, Commander? Now, what we are specifically interested in is, when these fellows come out from France, it's generally because they've had some trouble. Now, has he ever told you anything about that? Well, what do you know about his family?
Well, he has no family. No wife, nobody.
He hasn't any children?
No, sir.
And you say he's never told you why he left France?
Yes, sir. He left France because he killed a man.
Did he tell you why?
Nobody will if I ask him.
Well, Forbes, that's exactly what we'd like to have you do. Find out as much as you can about it. His background, his opinion, and why he killed this man in France.
In other words, you want me to spy on him?
Well, I'm afraid it is something like that.
Why? Do you suspect him of anything?
No, it's just that we don't know very much about him, and he's... Will you help us, Miss Forbes?
Right.
Thanks. You may go now, if you wish.
I don't know very much about him, really. Do I?
He's kept a few secrets from her, hasn't he?
Well, you don't spring a couple of Polynesian kids on a woman right off the bat.
I'm afraid we aren't going to get much out of her. She's obviously in love with him.
Why, that's hard to believe, sir. They tell me he's a middle-aged man.
Cable! It is the common mistake for boys of your age and athletic ability to underestimate men who have reached their maturity. Young women frequently find a grown man attractive, strange as it may seem to you. I myself am over 50. I am a bachelor, and Cable, I do not by any means consider myself through. What's the matter, Bill?
Nothing. Evidently.
Okay, Cable, see you at Cobb.
Yes.
You play bridge?
Yes, sir.
Did you get any money?
Yes, sir.
Good, I'll take it away from you.
Yes.
What makes you so damn sure this mission won't work?
Marie Louise Island is 24 miles long and 3 miles wide. Let's say every time they send out a message, they move to another hill. It seems to me, looking at this thing optimistically, they could last about a week. Of course, it would be worse if it were the right week. With decent information, our side might get moving.
Operation Alligator might get off its can.
Here it is.
See you at Cow, Bill. See you at Cow, Bill.
Yeah, sure, see you at Cow. Have you got the address right?
I think so, sir.
Mrs. Amelia Fortuna, 325 Euclid Avenue, Cleveland, Ohio.
That's right. I want a packet myself. Yeah.
Yeah.
More about me, how I live and think.
No more about you?
Yes, you know very little about me.
That's right. Oh, would you sit down? Do you think about politics much? And if so, what do you think about politics?
Do you mean by political philosophy?
Well, I think that's what I mean.
Well, to begin with, I believe in a free life, in freedom for everyone.
Like in the Declaration of Independence?
Sir, all men are created equal. Isn't it?
Emil, you really believe that?
Yes.
Well, thank goodness.
It is why I am here. Why I killed a man.
Oh, yes, I meant to ask you about that, too. I want to think I'm prying into your private life, asking you a lot of questions, but... Well, I always think it's interesting. Why a person kills another person.
Of course, Nellie, that has worried you. When I was a boy, I carried my heart in my hand. So, when this man came to our town, though my father said he was good, I thought he was bad. I was young. He attracted all the mean and cruel people to him. Soon he was running our town. He could do anything, take anything. I did not like that. I was young. He stood up in the public square and made a speech. I called upon everyone to stand with me against this man.
What did they do?
They walked away.
Why?
Because they saw him standing behind me. I turned. He said to me, I am going to kill you now. We fought. I was never so strong. I knocked him to the ground, and when he fell, his head struck a stone. I ran to the waterfront. I joined a cargo boat. I didn't even know where it was going. I stepped off that boat into another world. Where I am now, and where I want to stay.
Forget all of the men I have ever met.
Now, before you give us your answer, I want to respect you with three things. First, you are a civilian and you don't have to go. There is no way of our making you go. Second, this is a very dangerous mission and there is no guarantee that you will survive or that it will do any good. Third, that it might do a great good. It might be the means of turning the tide of war in this area.
I understand all these things.
Are you ready to give us your answer?
Yes, I am. My answer must be no. When a man faces death, he must weigh values very carefully. He must weigh the sweetness of his life against the thing he is asked to die for. The probability of death is very great for both of us. I know that island well, Lieutenant Cable. I am not certain that I believe that what you ask me to do is...
We're asking you to help us lick the Jap. It's as simple as that. We're against the Jap.
I know what you're against. What are you for? When I was 22, I thought the world hated bullies as much as I did. I was foolish. I killed one. I was forced to flee to an island. Since then, I have asked no help from anyone or any country. I have seen these bullies multiply and grow strong. The world can try and watch them.
How the hell will that affect? Let me up. Aren't you just a guy in love with a girl? And you're putting her above everything else in the world?
Yes. I do care about my life with her more than anything else in the world. It is the only thing that is important to me. This I believe in. This I am sure of. Please, I have. I cannot risk to lose. Good day, gentlemen.
He's an honest man, but he's wrong. Of course, we can't guarantee him a better world if we win. Point is, we can be damn sure it'll be worse if we lose, can't we?
Well, can't we?
Of course. There's a bottle of scotch in my bottom drawer, Cable. See you tomorrow.
This is the one he means.
Commander Harkinson, the old man walked right out on me with all these orders to be signed. And there's another delegation of French planters out here complaining about that stolen pig. The one that CB took and barbecued. And Commander Harkinson...
Okay, okay, I'll take care of it.
All right. Sir?
Well, that's all I do, Commander Harkinson. Go back to my outfit tonight?
No, take a couple of days off and unwind.
Unwind?
Sure, take a boat. Go fishing.
Boat?
Thank you.
Cat's the OC. Where's this?
Why, OC. On her. Are you afraid of me?
No. We. No.
Thank you.
supposed to be a religious man, I wouldn't have gotten up to dance with him. Here he comes! Here he comes!
No!
Billy, I have a surprise for you. Now, you sit over here, please. Something I have been preparing for 2 days. Now, close your eyes. No peeking. I'm gonna want that man right up to my hand. I'm gonna want that man right up to my hand. And take me all up to my hand. Don't try to punch it up. Tear it up, tear it up. Watch him up, light him up. Push him up, light him up. Stagger him. Stagger at him, no. Yay! What?
Why, you're the two things I ever saw in my life. What are your names? You gotta get a better word I'm saying, but by goodness, you're cute.
Nelly, I want you to meet Ghana and Jerome. Ghana and Jerome, Nelly.
Nelly?
Imagine that, only this and empty.
Bonsoir, Nelly. Bonsoir. Bonsoir.
Aren't they a go?
Those big black eyes staring at you out of those sweet little faces. Are they Henry?
Am I?
Of course, they look exactly like you, don't they? Where do you hide that mustache?
Get them.
And here they are, you.
Yes, then. I am their father.
And their mother?
Polynesia. And she was beautiful, Nelly. Charming. I want you to know I have no apology. I've been here as a young man. I lived as I could. I have not been selfish. No woman has ever hated me or tried to hurt me.
No woman could ever
want
to hurt you, ain't
you? I'm not stopping at that. Please, madam.
Oh,
all the time.
Nelly, wait, please, madam, right, you home. Will you do no such thing anyway? I just made the gate here. Don't go.
Now, Nelly, don't go yet, please.
I'll never be able to make the girl to the hospital. And that's where he'll get me. I'll be late. fellow, read it at the last number. The handstand is done by Marine Sergeant Kenneth Johnson. The Russian Savant star was done by Lieutenant J.D. Destiny Al Yeager.
Is that the one from Baker?
The fellow featuring the hit kick and scissors, those are the names of the set, was by Ensign Carl McRae and Ensign Connie Veluska. The multiple revolutions, and incidentally, the dance steps are by Ensign Nellie Corbett. Now, the next act is a most unusual thing. And
so the show will be a success, especially when they're on the committee.
You're on the committee, too. Why didn't you come to up and gas up?
Look, I'm acting in the show. I'm the stage manager and I'm the producer. I can't figure out everything, can I?
Sure you can. Just put your two heads together.
Look, jerk, I got a production on my hands. Well, how's the weightlifting act going?
Well, I can't tell.
Nobody's clapping. Well, if nobody's clapping, it ain't going good. You ought to be able to figure that out. Put your two heads together.
You was the one with the two heads.
Listen.
Mother, could you tell me where I could find Miss Morgan?
She's on the stage right now. She's the MC. She can't talk to nobody now. You want me to take those flowers in for you?
No, I would prefer to get them to her myself.
Are you Mr. DeBeck?
Yes.
Look, Mr. DeBeck, do me a big favor, will you? Don't try and see her tonight.
Why?
Well, we got her in a good mood, and I don't want nothing to upset her again.
She's been upset?
Upset? She asked for a transfer to another island. The day before yesterday, she broke out crying right in the middle of rehearsal. Said she couldn't follow the show. She wouldn't have either unless Captain Brackett came down and talked to her and told her out of court it wasn't for the men on the base. So look, do us all a big favor, will you? Don't try and see her now.
Transfer.
Don't tell her I told you. Nobody's supposed to know.
I must see her tonight.
Well, stay here then, out of sight until after the show. I'll take the flowers in for you.
I am worried about you. You're ill. Will you allow me to see you back to the hospital?
You're worried about me.
That's
funny. A fellow who said he lived on an island all by himself and doesn't worry about anybody. Japs, Americans, Germans, anybody. Why pick out me to worry about?
Thank you. Her feet. Came with him. Are you all right, Miss Forbush?
Uh-huh.
Well, I'll be hanging around the area in case you need me. Just sing out. Ready, girl?
What's the matter, Nellie the nurse? Having diplomatic difficulties with France?
Joe Cable, who let you out of the hospital?
Me, I'm...
You're trying to get over to Valley High.
To
that old girl you told me about.
Yes. I've just seen her. For the last time, I guess.
Joe.
Nellie, I love her.
And yet I just heard myself saying I couldn't marry her. What's the matter with me, Nellie? What kind of a guy am I anyway?
You're all right, it's just that you're so far away from home. You're both so far away from home.
Nellie, I must see you.
Emil?
Will you excuse us, Lieutenant Campbell?
A minute, Joe, please. I've been meaning to call you, Emil.
You have asked for a transfer. Why? What does it mean?
I'll explain tomorrow.
No, not tomorrow. Now. What does it mean, Nellie?
It means that I can't marry you. Do you understand? I can't marry you.
Because of my children?
Not because of your children. They're sweet.
It is their Polynesian mother, then. Their mother and I.
Yes. I can't help it. It isn't as if I could give you a good reason. There is no reason. This is emotional. It's something that's born in me.
It is not. I do not believe this is born in you.
Why do I feel the way I do? All I know is I can't help it. I can't help it. You explain how we feel, please, Joe.
Nellie.
Honey, are you ready?
Yes, Nellie. Over here.
What makes her talk like that? Why do you have this feeling you achieve? I do not believe it is born in you. I do not believe it.
It's not born in you.
Thank you.
consider going up there with me, Marie Louise Island? I mean, now you haven't got so much to lose.
We can do a good job, I think.
You and I. You know, back home when I used to get in a jam, I used to go hunting. That's what I think I'll do now. But hunting up there around Marie Louise. Jet carriers, cargo boats, troop ships. Big game. When I go up, what side of the island should I land?
The south side.
Why?
There is a cove there with rocks. I have sailed in behind these rocks many times.
Submarine sail in between those rocks without being observed?
Yes, if you know the channel.
After I land, what will I do?
You will get in touch with two of my friends, Lucille and Inato. Two black men. Wonderful hunters. They will hide us in the hills.
Are you going with me?
Of course. You're too young to be out alone. Let's find Captain Brackett.
Wait till old Iron Belly hears about this. He'll jump out of his skin.
Hey, I would like to see this kind of a jump. Come on.
Tin roof. It's the mist cooling off at night.
So,
sir, if you'd like to go back to your office, I'll let you know just as...
No. I don't want to ask you your problems. I'll stay right here.
Yes, sir.
We ought to be getting a message. We ought to be getting a message, that's all. They've been trying to land and establish some sort of an observation post by now. Don't you think so?
Oh,
Captain Brackett. Look, what is it? What is it? Don't interrupt me now, Bill. I'm very busy. It's about this CB out here.
Billis. Commander Perkins over at operations. Estimates of Billis's act this morning cost the Navy over
$600,000. $600,000.
By God, I'm going to chew that guy's...
Son of a...
Yes, sir. Look, let me know the minute you get any word. No matter what I'm doing, break right in.
Yes, sir.
Get in there.
Captain Brackett, this is Lieutenant Buzz Adams who flew the mission.
Captain.
Hi, Adams.
You in an outfit is like a rotten apple in a barrel. Just what did you feel like sitting down there all day long in that little rubber boat in the middle of Empress Augusta Bay with the whole damn Navy Air Force trying to rescue you? And how the hell can you fall out of a Catalina anyway?
Well, sir, the Japanese aircraft busted a hole in the side of the plane and I fell through. The wind just... Suck me out!
So I'm to understand that you deliberately hid in the baggage compartment of a plane that you knew was taking off on a very dangerous mission. You had nerve enough to do that, all right. And the minute an anti-aircraft gun hit the plane, you fell out. The wind just sucked you out. You and your little parachute. I don't think you fell out, Philip. I think you jumped out. Now, which did you do?
Well, sir, it was sort of half and half. If you get the picture.
This is one of the most humiliating things that's ever happened to me. Adam, when did you discover he was on the plane?
Well, sir, we've been out about an hour. It was still dark, I know. We were flying across Mary Louise. Japanese aircraft spotted us and made that hit. That's a loser. And this fella here, that's when he... left the ship. I just circled once, time enough to drop my rubber boat. Some New Zealanders, B-40s, spotted them though and kept circling over them while I flew across the island and landed alongside the South. Let Joe and the French and all. By the time I got back to the other side of the island, our Navy planes were flying around the air above this guy like a thick swarm of bees. They kept the Jap guns occupied while I slipped down and scooped him off the rubber boat. You know about this guy was a $90 million cruiser they were out to protect. There must have been 55 or 60 planes.
62. You're not far off, Adam. Harbison tells me this thing costs the Navy about $600,000.
$600,000?
What the hell are you so happy about?
I was just thinking about my uncle. You remember my uncle I was telling you about? He used to tell my old man I'd never be worth a dime. Him and his lousy slot machine. Can you imagine the nerve of a guy?
Why the hell did you do this anyway, Philip? What would make a man do a thing like this?
Well, sir, a fella has to keep moving, you get kind of held down. And if a guy's itching to take a trip to pick up some souvenirs, you gotta kind of horn in, if you get the picture.
How did you know about it?
Well, I didn't know about it exactly. Just when I heard Lieutenant Cable talk to that fella DeBeck, right away I figured something's in the air. A project. Now that's what I like, Captain. Projects! Don't you?
Willis, you've broken every regulation in the book. And by God, Captain Bragg and I are gonna throw it!
Sir, may I barge in? My co-pilot watched this whole thing, you know, and he thinks this fellow Phillips, down there in the rubber boat, with all those planes over him, caused a kind of diversionary action. All those Jap guns were busy shooting at the planes. And that Phillips. On the other side of the island, that submarine was sliding into that little cove and depositing the Frenchman and Joe Cable in behind those rocks.
What the hell do you want me to do? Pin a medal on this guy?
I don't want no medal, Captain. But I could use a little freedom. A little room to kind of swing around in. You know what I mean? If you get the picture,
get out of here. Get out of here! Sure. Get the hell out of here! Well, Iron Belly, what would you have done? I'd have thrown him in the brick. And I will too if I get the ghost of a chance.
Oh. And so we are here. This is our first chance to send news to you. We have made contact with former friends of mine. We have set up quarters in a mango tree. No room, but a lovely view. First, the weather. Rain clouds over Bougainville, the Treasuries, Quarter, and New Georgia. We expect rain in this region from 9 o'clock to 4 o'clock. Pardon? Oh, my friend Joe corrects me. 0900 to 1400. And now our military expert, Joe.
All you Navy, Marine, and Army pilots, write this down. Surface craft. 19 troop barges headed down the bottleneck. Speed about 11 knots.
on the Pasmanita at about 20 hundreds a night, escorted by heavy warships. Ought to be some way to knock out a few of these.
Oh, boy.
Where
I don't want to miss there that thing. We'll be going out to tonight.
But 20! That is, without my 600 headed southwest. There was quite a rest. Not heavy. They could reach.
You know what I like, Bill?
What? Don't you?
All right.
City today, unlimited. 33 fighters, zeros, have moved in from booking here. Their cost is approximately 23 degrees. We believe that the bombers will follow.
Well, gentlemen, here's a hot tip for today. Joe and the Frenchman have sighted plenty service craft heading southeast to the Bella La Bella. This is just 2 weeks away. What is there to get those two characters of the present? A beautiful view of no ship coming back. Okay, that's all right with me. Let's go!
Yes, sir.
Tell her something sometime. She hasn't seen him for 2 weeks. She might as well know it now.
Okay, send her in, send her in.
I always have to do that tough job.
Captain Brackett, I know this isn't regular. It was about Amy or the bed. I went to his house a week ago to... Well, you know how people have arguments, and days later you think of a good answer. Well, I went to his house, and he wasn't there. I even asked the children. Oh, he has two little children, and they don't seem to know where he's gone. At least that's what I think they said. They only speak French. And then tonight, when I was on duty in the ward, we have a lot of fighter pilots over there. You know, the boys who knocked out that convoy yesterday, and you know how fighter pilots talk about emblems and wing overs and things. And I never listen, usually, but they kept talking about a Frenchman. They said the Frenchman said this, and the Frenchman said that, and... I was just wondering if this Frenchman they're talking about could be my Frenchman.
Yes, Miss Forbush, it is. I couldn't tell you before. As a matter of fact, if you wait around here a few minutes, you'll be able to hear his voice.
His voice? Where is he?
With Lieutenant Cable behind enemy lines.
Behind?
Hello. Hello, my friends and allies. My message today must be brief and sad. Lieutenant Cable, my friend Joe, died last night. He died from wounds he received 3 days ago. I will never know a finer man. I wish he could have told you the good news. The Japanese are pulling out, and there is great confusion. Our guess is that the Jap will try to evacuate troops from Kingsville tonight. You may not hear from us for several days. We must move again. Two planes are overhead. They are looking for us, we think. We believe that.
Goodbye! Is that all? Is that all? Can't forget the black holes in there. Cut off!
Joe!
Thank you.
be the first time we met. He owed me that night to you, to Liberty.
Remedy, you'll be needing it.
Knock up. That's stuff issue. We all got them. Who are you trying to fool?
You know, these Marines are getting smarter every day.
All right. Stay with the unit. Henson, you too. For heaven's sake, don't get spread out over here. I'm trying to get this thing organized as quickly as possible. So for God's sake, stay with your outfit. Hey, Phoebe.
Excuse me, sir. Can you tell me where I can find Captain Brackett?
He's up ahead of the company street. He'll be along any minute now.
Thank you, sir. That's all.
Keep an eye down there. Howdy, how's my coat? Keep an eye.
And remember, you guys are going to volunteer, too. I'm Miss McGregor. You nurses going along, too?
Only a few of us. We're going to fly back to wounded.
Is Forbush going with you?
Oh, I don't know. She may have to use the hospital.
Oh. Say, Miss McGregor, you don't happen to get airsick, do you? I was thinking maybe if you have $3 handy, you might be able to use this little package I got here.
Ah, that stuff no good? They gave that up last month.
That is a female shirt. Excuse me, sir. Could I speak to you for a minute?
Who is it?
Phillips, sir. Luther Phillips.
Well, what is it, Phillips? We're moving out pretty soon.
Yes, sir, I know. I kind of like to do something for Miss Forbush, sir. A stupid the professor and me was wondering if anything was being done about rescuing a Frenchman off that island. We hereby volunteer for such a project, sir. A kind of a triple diversionary activity, like I've done to get them on there. You could drop us in 3 rubber boats on 3 different sides of the island. Confuse the hell out of them Japs. Get the picture.
That's very fine of you, Phyllis, but I'm afraid it's a little late for diversionary activity. That started this morning before the sun came up. Operation Alligator got underway. Landings were made on 14 Japanese held islands.
That's very unfair, sir. I think the first thing they should have done was try and rescue that Frenchman.
The Admiral agrees with you, Phyllis. Marie Louise was the first island they hit.
Did they get him? Is he alive?
We don't know. Lieutenant Buzz Ennis flew up there to find out. He hasn't come back yet.
But if the Frenchman's dead, it is unfair. It's too damn bad of a part of this huge operation couldn't have saved one of the 2 guys who made it all possible.
Look at that beach. As far as you can see, men waiting to board ships. The whole picture of the South Pacific has changed. We're going the other way.
Captain Brackett, sir, the launch is ready to take us to your ship.
You got a ship, sir?
Yes, Thompson and I have got a ship. I am no longer a lousy island commander. Go on, Bill.
So long, Captain Brackett.
So long, Phyllis. Oh, by the way, We never did get you in the brig, did we?
No.
No, I forgot.
Forgot what, sir?
Your unit will be on my ship. I'll be seeing all of you. Get the picture?
All right, let's start those trucks moving out. All units on the company street, we're ready to load them. All nurses will board assigned planes. CBs to embark off carrier 6. All marines to LCT. Any questions? Move on!
Let's